Lord Devil. This gonna be Buck's last day amongst the living.
What exactly he do to you?
Call it a professional robbery.
I know who you are. That love. Outlaw hunts down those who trespass against him with no mercy.
Where is he?
Where is who?
Your boss.
My boss. Clearly, you don't know me.
Denise Woods is a renowned vocal and dialect coach who has helped some of Hollywood's biggest stars, like you just saw, in The Harder They Fall.
And Denise joins us now with more on unlocking the power of your voice. Bravo,
yes.
Denise. You taught them how to speak with that dialect. How do you do something like that?
Well, first of all, good morning.
Good morning.
Good to be here. You have to have an ear. You have to develop an ear for it, an ear for sounds of speech. You have to hear the musicality in speech. But more importantly, you have to love and appreciate the differences in speech, which is what I do. I welcome a myriad of voices in my space. And I don't like to pigeonhole one voice as being less than or one dialect being less than another dialect. I embrace it all so that the world becomes my palette. And then I just curate different dialects for actors in Hollywood. That's basically what I do. And then I teach them, not just curate them, but then I teach the actors how to affect it, where the voice is placed in the mouth, where the sounds are, the cadence and the rhythm. It's so much fun.
There are so many different dialects in this world. So many different dialects in every country. How did you learn to do this that you could then teach someone else?
Well, I started out as an actress. I studied at the Juilliard School back in the 70s. Robin Williams was 2 years ahead of me at Juilliard.
Oh, wow.
Keith David was in my class at Juilliard. Voice and speech was really, really huge in the drama division at Juilliard. Mm-hmm. It still is. But back in the day, in the 70s, we studied with the grand dame of American speech. And so we all came out quite proficient in the international phonetic alphabet, meaning that for every sound of speech, ladies, there is a notation. Like there is a musical note for musical tones, there is a notation for every sound of speech.
Huh.
And I happen to know all of the symbols for the international phonetic sounds, but also mainly American sounds.
Some people are such powerful orators because they know how to hone that power. And that is what you tend to teach people, especially in your new book, about how to use their voice as power in their lives. Correct?
Absolutely. It's interesting because when I segue from Hollywood and go to everyday people, CEOs of companies, people that use their voices, such as yourselves, ladies, people that use their voices for a living, not just performing, but for a living, what I tell them is know your audience. Know your audience, know who you're speaking to, do your research, but more importantly, have an objective. What do I want to do with this audience? If it's an audience of one, or if it's an audience of hundreds, what do I want to accomplish? Give yourself a goal, intention. And what that does is it makes your speech and your voice more succinct when you give yourself intention.
I don't think people put enough stock in this, but if you think about someone you know who is a meek person, they could be wickedly intelligent, but they can't get that across to someone if they don't have the right speaking capabilities.
That's right, and it's really simple. You know, I wanted to take this technique to the masses, which is the reason why I wrote the book. It's part memoir. I talk about my journey and my vocal journey, as well as anecdotal. I have stories from everyday people, Hollywood stars. Mahershala Ali, as you see here, wrote the foreword. But I also have tales and stories from people like Halle Berry and Soledad O'Brien and athletes. Because what I want is to encourage people to be the best version of themselves, not to affect, oh, I want to sound like Meryl Streep, or I want to sound like Viola Davis. Be the best version of yourself. And there are tools. So I give you not just stories and my stories and other people's stories, but I give you a how-to. It's prescriptive as well.
And that is important, because I remember when I first started out in television, I had poor diction. I couldn't pronounce words correctly. So there are actually exercises that you have to go through in order to be effective in speaking.
Absolutely. I say what I do is what scales are for a musician. A musician doesn't just come in and play the piece, play the piano. A singer doesn't just come in and sing the song. I didn't just show up here. I've been warming up for an hour prior to my coming here. Yeah, it's preparation. And so that's what I want people to do, because preparation doesn't only prepare you, but it gives you confidence when you know what you're doing.
We all need that.
And I think that's the bottom line, ladies, is confidence. Particularly, I find for women and marginalized communities, people of color, you know, transgender women, people, you know, just because society has said that our voices in some way don't matter. Our voices don't matter, either subliminally or overtly. We have to take the bull by the horns and just drive it. Make your voice heard, folks.
All right, Denise, we're going to have to leave it there, but thank you so much. You can get Denise's book and you can learn the power of your voice.
Thanks, Denise.
Thank you, Denise.